So is Python a good programming language when it comes to large-scale game development? The short answer is no. Python is used more for web development, machine learning, data science, etc. But is Python completely useless when it comes to making games? And what are the good languages at making games, if not Python? I will answer all of these questions in the next 5 minutes. So as you might have heard other people say, Python in the 21st century is one of the best languages today, obviously. And in my opinion, it is actually the best language to learn first in 2020. So why might that be? And here leads to my first point of why Python might not be the top choice for game development. So Python is pretty easy to start with. It has a pretty easy syntax to deal with for beginners, and you can get started pretty quickly. You can understand variables, lists, dictionary, and so on. Everything's just pretty simple compared to other languages. Unlike C or C++ or C Sharp or Java or something, they might be a bit more verbose, and there's loads of words in it, and there's loads of stuff that beginners might not understand when they just start. So Python is a bit easier to start. And here comes the problem. Although Python is pretty easy to start with, it gets pretty difficult as you move on. Unlike C, C++, or some of the other game development languages, it's pretty easy actually when you move on and make complicated games. If I were to rewrite the game Minecraft, for example, in 1 week, I would probably go for using the game engine Unity, which supports C Sharp, or go to something like Unreal Engine, which supports C++. Do something like that, and it's pretty easy. And obviously, not many game engines, at least not one of the famous ones, actually support Python. So it's not very good for game development in that way. Moreover, here comes my second point of why Python is not good for large-scale game development. If I were to rank all of the programming languages in the list from top to bottom in terms of speed, Python would be near the bottom. In fact, probably at the bottom, all of the popular programming languages at least. And then at the top, first, in my opinion, even in 2020, it is the language C. And then second, C++. Third, Java, and then so on. So, in fact, in some applications and some programs, C, C++, and Java, or some of those languages, can do things about 100 times, even 200 times faster than the native Python. So, as you can see, Python is an extremely, extremely, extremely slow language. On the other hand, although Python is takes less time to develop things, i.e., if I were to write a program, the same program in Python, it would probably only take 20 minutes, whereas I have to write it in an hour if I were to do it in C or Java. But obviously, that does not change anything about the actual speed of the language. And here, let me clarify the term large-scale game development, something I've used multiple times in this video. And what I mean by that is probably like multiplayer game, that is a kind of large-scale game. So obviously, you want very, very fast connection, very, very fast connection between the data center and the player's device, either phone, Xbox, PC, whatever. So in which case, you would need a very fast language. Obviously, you would not want a slow language like Python. Instead, you would probably want to do it with C Sharp, for example, Unity language. Unity is obviously one of the best game engines nowadays. So yeah, you will obviously want to use one of those fast languages in order to secure the connection and have the best possible experience for the players. Python might not be the top choice when it comes to making games of bigger scales, but that definitely does not mean that it is incapable of making smaller games. Here are a couple of games which I did in my spare time, so just to show you guys. So this one, I use the module TK Inter. If you ever study Python here, would know this module. So it is for graphical user interface. So yeah, this project only has 135 lines of code, so it's a pretty simple one, and it didn't take me that long. But let's just check it out. It's a bat and ball game where you have to use the arrow keys to control the bat, and then every time you hit the ball, you get a plus 100 score, which is going to record on the other screen. Also, the ball gets a bit faster every time. And then when you die, it actually asks you, do you want to play again? In which case, if I click yes, then it just gets me back. But if I click no, obviously it just quits. So it says your score was 100. So yeah, obviously this is a very simple game, but yeah, I just proved that you can definitely make games using Python. So here is the second mini game which I made myself, for you guys to see. So yeah, this time I used the Pygame module, which is perhaps the best like game making module in Python. So this game is slightly like more complicated, slightly bigger. This has 250 lines of code, and it includes music and sound effects and so on. Let's just run this. So yeah, you see when the enemy hits me, I get -5, but I can also press the space bar to shoot the enemy, and then once the enemy is dead, like so, he's just gone.
And I haven't really like made a second enemy or like a second level or anything like that, or loading screen, but I can definitely work on that later, just to add more things in.
So now that I've told you that Python is not the ideal choice for large-scale game development, what are the ideal choices when it comes to programming languages at making games? Well, here I'm going to list out three languages that I think are the ideal choices in 2020. First up, we have C++. C++ is an absolutely fan favourite and programmer's favourite when it comes to making games, and that is because there are loads of great game engines that actually support C++, and the fact that it is basically C, but also it has classes and objects. It's an object-oriented language, and it's just a lot better. So obviously the Unreal Engine, the ancient engine that actually runs the game Fortnite, is uses the C++ language. So Unreal Engine is obviously one of the best game engines nowadays. It allows Blueprint as well as the language C++ itself. So not just Unreal Engine, C++, if you look at some of the best games nowadays, most of them actually have C++ in them. And like maybe it's the server code, maybe it's the player code, but it doesn't really matter. There's always some sort of C++ in them. That just shows how like huge C++ is when it comes to game development. Yeah, that's my top choice, top number one choice in 2020. Number two, I would say the language C#, ran by Microsoft, obviously one of the richest companies in the world right now. So it's constantly being fixed and improved, the language C#. So Unity, another game engine, I'd say probably the most used one nowadays, and it supports C#, and that for a good reason as well, because C# is a very versatile and good language for making games. It is also very fast, as I said earlier on in the video. Now here comes my third and final choice when it comes to making games, and that is language Java. So a best example would be the game Minecraft, Minecraft Java Edition, as you probably know. So there's a good reason why it uses Java. Java is very flexible, so you can make loads of mods and realms and stuff with it. So you can do loads of other stuff other than the actual original Minecraft. And also it is reasonably fast, and although some people might say it's quite contains loads of unnecessary words and unnecessary stuff, but that definitely just strengthens the language itself, and it just makes it faster and more stable. Thank you all so much for watching this video. I really hope that you enjoyed this video as well as learning a lot in the process. So this video did take me quite a while to make due to all the preparations and all the research beforehand. So dropping a single like down below would be very appreciated. So if you like the video, make sure you subscribe as well in order to keep up with my latest uploads, as well as comment as well if you want, just to give me some video ideas and what you would like to see in the future. So a lot of you have been asking me about my uploading schedule, i.e. when I upload and how often do I upload and everything. So I usually plan on uploading every weekend, but since it's quarantine right now, I'll try my best to upload more during the week as well, like maybe one or two videos if I have the time to. So yeah, that just gives you more reason to subscribe to this channel right now, but apart from that, I love every single one of you, and I'll see you guys in the next one.